When we offer the sacrifice, this is a commemoration of Ibrahim alayhi to be ready to sacrifice his own son for the pleasure of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. When the Hujjaj met Tawaf and Sa'i, this is all the commemoration of Ibrahim alayhi salam and the family of Ibrahim alayhi salam, their sacrifices, their surrender, their submission to the will of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. The legacy of Ibrahim alayhi salam and his wife Hajar alayhi salam and their son Ismail alayhi salam. This is a legacy that is immense, and it is a legacy that can never be forgotten. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says about Ibrahim alayhi salam and his attitude and his mindset, إِذْ قَالَ لَهُ رَبُّهُ أَسْلِمْ قَالَ أَسْلَمْتُ لِرَبِّ الْعَالَمِينَ قَالَ أَسْلَمْتُ لِرَبِّ الْعَالَمِينَ. When the Lord of Ibrahim and Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said to Ibrahim alayhi salam, أَسْلِمْ, submit to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, what did Ibrahim alayhi salam respond? He said, قَالَ أَسْلَمْتُ لِرَبِّ الْعَالَمِينَ, I submit and completely surrender to the will of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. I submit myself to the Lord of the worlds, to Allah, the Lord of the worlds. This is the legacy of Ibrahim alayhi salam, a legacy of complete submission to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, obeying Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala without question and without hesitation. And this is something that we need to find in our own selves as well. When we see that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has commanded something, we say, Sami'na wa ta'ala, we hear and we obey. When we see that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has prohibited something, we stay away from that thing without any question and without any hesitation. This is what we learn from the legacy of Ibrahim alayhi salam. Follow the commands of Allah in all circumstances. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala allow us to emulate this great legacy. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala make us from the true Muslimin. The word Muslim, it means someone who submits themselves to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And Ibrahim alayhi salam was a beautiful example of someone who submitted himself to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. As Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, مَا كَانَ إِبْرَاهِيمُ يَهُودِيًّا وَلَا نَصْرَانِيًّا وَلَكِنْ كَانَ حَنِيفًا مُسْلِمًا وَمَا كَانَ مِنَ الْمُشْرِكِينَ. Ibrahim alayhi salam, he was not a Jew nor a Christian, but he was applying the pure monotheistic belief, the belief in Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala as the only one worthy of worship, and he was a Muslim. He submitted himself to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, وَمَا كَانَ مِنَ الْمُشْرِكِينَ, and he was not from those who associated partners with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Allahu Akbar, Allahu Akbar, Allahu Akbar, La ilaha illallah, Allahu Akbar, Allahu Akbar, Wa ilaha illallah. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala allow us to revive these lessons from the legacy of Ibrahim alayhi salam and this day. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala allow us to live lives that are pleasing to Him, lives in submission to Him, and may Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala accept it from us all. Amen. بارك الله لكم في القرآن العظيم ونفعني وإياكم بالهدي سيدنا المرسلين. أقول ما تسمعون وأستغفر الله العظيم الجليل لي ولكم ولجميع المسلمين من كل ذنب فاستغفروه إنه هو الغفور الرحيم. الحمد لله الذي هدانا للإسلام أكمله لنا وأتمه علينا ورضي قول نبينا. أحمده تعالى وأشكره وأستعينه وأستغفره وأثني عليه الخير كله وأشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له. هو الأول وعليه المعول وهو المبتدا ومنه المبتدا وإليه المنتهى. وأشهد أن سيدنا ونبينا محمدا عبد الله ورسوله هذه البرية ومعلم البشرية مجدد الحنيفية صلى الله عليه وعلى آله وجميع الأطهار وصحابته الأبرار والتابعين الأخيار صلوات تامات كان لكن متعاقبات ما تعقب الليل والنهار وسبب التسليم الكثير. الله أكبر، الله أكبر، الله أكبر، لا إله إلا الله، الله أكبر، الله أكبر، ولله الحمد. My dear brothers and sisters, the first 10 days of Dhul Hijjah, along with the 3 days that follow Eid, the 11th, 12th, and the 13th, which are known as Eidan al-Tashriq, these are days of the remembrance of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. These are days where we should constantly be reciting the Takbir, praising Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, declaring the greatness of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Allahu Akbar, Allahu Akbar, Allahu Akbar, لا إله إلا الله الله أكبر الله أكبر ولا إله إلا الله. So this is something we should have been doing on a regular basis from the beginning of this month, and it should continue today, and it should also continue for the next 3 days inshallah, as much as possible. Revive the sunnah of the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Allahu Akbar, Allahu Akbar, Allahu Akbar, La ilaha illallah, Allahu Akbar, Allahu Akbar, wa lillahi l-hamd. Also from the great acts of worship that are performed on the day of Eid, and it's also permissible to perform this in the coming days of Ayyam al-Tashreeq, the 11th of the 15th, as well as the Khutbah, offering a sacrifice. And this, of course, is in commemoration of the Prophet alayhi salam's willingness to sacrifice his son to fulfill the command of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And when he was ready to sacrifice his son, both of them submitted to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Ibrahim alayhi salam, he proved himself that he was sincere to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala replaced the sacrifice with a ram instead. So Ismail alayhi salam was saved, the ram was slaughtered, and this is the basis of what we do every year. The Ul-Adha that we perform every year is an act of worship for Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. It actually commemorates the willingness of the Prophet alayhi salam to submit to the command of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So this is one of the great acts of worship that we can perform either today or in the following few days on the Qiyam al-Layl. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says about the sacrifice, تَيَّنَا لَلَّهَ لُكُمُهَا وَلَا تِنَالُهَا وَلَا تِنَالُهَا وَلَا تِنَالُهَا مِنْهُ. That the meat of these animals will not reach Allah. The blood of these animals that spills, it will not reach Allah. But what will reach Allah is the taqwa that comes from you. Your willingness to submit to a command of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. This is what reaches Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. This is what you reward him. So may Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala make us all from the people who follow the sunnah of the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, and who follow the way of the Prophet Ibrahim alayhi wa sallam. As Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala even commanded our messenger, he commanded the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, فِيمَا أَوْحَيْنَا إِلَيْكَ أَنِ اتَّبِعْ مِلَّةَ إِبْرَاهِيمَ أَمِنْهُ. May we reveal to you to follow the way of Ibrahim alayhi wa sallam. Follow the monotheistic way of Ibrahim alayhi wa sallam. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala make us all from the people who follow this way, who stay upon this way during our lives, and who die on the state of submission to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. وَلَا تَمُوتُنَّ إِلَّا وَأَنْتُمْ مُسْلِمُونَ. Do not die except in a state of submission to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. As a Muslim, may Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala grant this to all of us. Amen. Allahu Akbar, 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 Allahu Akbar. هذا وصلنا وسلم ورحمه الله على رسول المجتبى والنبي المصطفى كما امركم بها لقاؤكم جل وعلا. فقال عز من قائل: ان الله وملائكته يصلون على النبي يا ايها الذين امنوا صلوا عليه وسلموا تسليما. اللهم صل وسلم وبارك على نبينا وحبيبنا محمد بن عبد الله. اللهم صل على محمد وعلى ال محمد كما صليت على ابراهيم وعلى ال ابراهيم انك حميد مجيد. اللهم بارك على محمد وعلى ال محمد كما باركت على ابراهيم وعلى ال ابراهيم انك حميد مجيد. سبحان ربك رب العزه عما يصفون وسلام على المرسلين والحمد لله رب العالمين. الله اكبر الله